Good morning. If this is the first time that you've clicked on one of my videos, welcome. My name is Claire Hawkins and I'm a traveling singer-songwriter currently living in Dublin, Ireland. I've decided that today we're gonna go on a little food tour around Dublin, but this is not gonna be your everyday average food tour. This is going to be a food tour specifically for Irish comfort foods. Now I know that videos like this, whether they're food tours or videos where you're just sort of eating a lot of food that you might not otherwise eat all in one day, can seem a bit wasteful, and I don't want to be wasteful, so I've done two things to combat that. One is that I've invited my Irish friend Florence along for the fun, so she will be helping me eat all the food to make sure that nothing goes to waste. And then on top of that, I've also decided that whatever amount I spend on food today in Dublin, I will donate the same amount to Simon Community Ireland. Simon Community is a really great charity. It specifically exists to combat homelessness here in Ireland. There are several different chapters across the country. Of course, because I'm in Dublin, I feel like I should be donating to the Dublin chapter, so that's what I will be doing. So with all that said, before I head into town, I have to start an Irish food video with a very important Irish drink, which is tea. We are here at our first location of our Dublin City comfort food tour, which is Centra. Now, if you live in Ireland or you're from here, you are very familiar with Centra, in which case, please bear with me as I explain to the rest of us what Centra is. Essentially, it's where you go for a snack, a drink, a newspaper, anything you want to kind of grab and take with you on the go. And it is a great place for three of the things that are on our list today. My arms are full, but there's one more thing that we need. Okay, so we did buy quite a haul of food at Centra, but we are starting very importantly with a chicken fillet roll and Lucozade. So Lucozade is kind of like Gatorade or Powerade. It's an energy drink. It's one that I think people most commonly drink after a night out. And then the chicken fillet roll. Now, if you're like me, you might be thinking, Claire, why are you pronouncing the T in fillet? I don't know. That's how they say it here. Essentially, it's just a sandwich with chicken fillet and butter, I think is all they put on this one. Sometimes you can get it with lettuce or tomato. Some people like mayo. I cannot possibly comprehend eating mayonnaise, but you know, you got some options. But essentially, it's just a sandwich. Everyone, please welcome Florence to the vlog. Florence is helping me eat a ridiculous amount of food today, so we are very grateful to her. And also, you are my token Irish person today, so she's gonna correct anything that I say wrong, which already I left out that a lot of people get these with cheese, and I don't eat cheese, but that's a whole other story. All right, cheers.
I've never had a chicken fillet roll this plain.
It is literally just chicken and butter. It's pretty good.
Give us the option of adding salad.
No. It's not bad. By the way, we're kneeling because there's absolutely nowhere to sit. So. Alright, it's time for Lucozade. I'm not sure if I've ever had one of these before. Oh my gosh, that tastes way more like soda. That does not taste like Gatorade. This tastes like Sprite, like full-on soda. It's delicious, but is this good for you? So overall, for our first, we'll call it course of this never-ending day-long meal, not bad. I would say chicken fillet roll was like maybe a 6 out of 10, and Lucozade, maybe also a 6 out of 10. I don't know. I don't really understand what I'm drinking, to be honest. We are here at Trinity College, which is, as I'm sure you're aware, kind of a staple in terms of Dublin tourist sites. We are going to continue our little picnic vibe here with Taytos. The interesting thing about Taytos, or at least I find it interesting, is that their sort of like neutral or classic flavor is cheese and onion, which to me is a very specific flavor. I feel like normally we would have like sea salt would be our neutral flavor in the US. Other thing that I need to address, crisps. I'm gonna try not to call them chips. I don't know if I've had these before. I feel like I must have at some point. We'll see. Those are pretty good to be fair. They don't taste super cheesy to me. I don't really eat crisps very often in general, but I would give these like a 7 out of 10. Yeah, a 7. It has started to rain because we're in Ireland, so we're gonna do one last little outdoorsy, picnicky food from our haul from Centra, and then the rest of our food tour will be hopefully indoors. So we have red TK lemonade, which I have never tried before. It's essentially a soda, and as you can tell, they don't sell it in small quantities. So I did have to buy this ginormous bottle, and I don't have cups, so we're just going all in, and I'm gonna drink it from the 2-liter bottle. I don't drink a lot of soda, so it's hard for me to say whether or not I would drink this outside of filming a Dublin comfort food tour. It's not bad, but I also think it kind of tastes the same as the Lucozade, so I'm gonna give it a 6 out of 10. But if you like soda, and particularly red flavor, you would love this. We are here at our next location, which is Charlie's. Charlie's is a Irish Chinese fast food restaurant, and it is delicious. We are here to get some curry chips. Now, that is not necessarily a very Chinese dish, but it is something that you can find at Chinese restaurants here in Ireland. You can also find it at most fast food type places. I am so excited about this. The curry sauce is kind of like gravy. So if you're familiar with poutine from Canada, it's not really similar, but it's like in the general family of fries covered in sauce. This feels very much like a talk show setup. Like, welcome to Florence and Claire eating all day.
Curry chips. That just tastes like night out comfort to me.
Does it feel weird to be eating them during daylight?
I feel like, yes, I've been transported to the end of a night out.
I genuinely do think these are better than other curry chips I've had in other places. I think the sauce is up a level. I don't know. Really good. 9 out of 10.
Ooh.
That's
a very high score from you.
Really, really good.
I think I might be more excited about this stop than every other stop combined. And that is because we are about to have a spice bag. Essentially, any Chinese restaurant that you go to here in Ireland probably has a spice bag on their menu. Now, I don't think that you'll find a spice bag anywhere else outside of this country. I would love to know if it exists elsewhere, but as far as I know, it is a very specific Irish Chinese restaurant dish, and it is so good. It is basically chicken nuggets and french fries in a bag with a ton of spices shaken up. There are many, many places that you can get a spice bag here in Dublin, but in my personal opinion, we are here at the best of the best.
I have to say, 11 out of 10. This is my favorite.
Now you might recognize the pub behind me. It is where we shot the music video for my song Dublin. We are headed in for a pint of Guinness. It's the only way to properly end this Dublin City food tour.
So we choose Sláinte.
It's never bad. It's never bad. It's 10 out of 10 every time.
Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed our silly little food tour around Dublin. I will add that, of course, there are many different types of cuisine here. It's not all junk food, but this was just to show one side of all that Ireland has to offer. My total spend for the day was €31.20, and I will add a sort of cost breakdown on the screen now if you're curious how much each individual thing cost. I decided to round up my donation to €35, and I have sent that off to Simon Community Dublin. I've also included a link in the video description if you want to learn more about the work that they do or even make a donation yourself. If you like this video, please let me know your thoughts in the comments, and of course make sure to subscribe. Thanks again for watching, and I'll talk to you soon. I'm working on my forest.